Let's play a little this or that.
Do you bypass a plugin or deactivate it? Bypassing is great for ABing or bypass automation. The plugin is still processing, but it's not outputting the result. And you can also bypass with a key command. I'm using option A, and that's this one, activate or deactivate focused object, which is actually kind of confusing because we're not deactivating, we're not turning it off, we're bypassing. But you can completely deactivate it in the plugin window, that's this on-off button. In the insert slot, it's holding option or alt and clicking. And now your computer is no longer processing the plugin. By the way, that's also what happens when you activate this one, constrained delay compensation. In short, what that does is when you have a lot of tracks with plugins that need some time to process the signal, some tracks are going to be delayed because of these plugins. And you can see that in your mix console as well, the delay or latency for every track and the plugins that are causing it. But you're not going to hear that delay because Cubase compensates for it to make sure that all tracks are still playing in sync. If not, that would be very annoying. A side effect of that compensation is that the whole project is going to have some latency. So when you're recording a vocal or a VST instrument, you might experience some uncomfortable latency. So that's when you press this button, constrained delay compensation. Cubase is then going to stop compensating for all those different delays on the tracks, but in order for the tracks to still play in sync, it's going to have to turn off the problematic plugins. And now the latency only depends on your buffer size. And when you're done recording, you can turn this back off. Next, clip gain or volume automation. Clip gain means changing the volume of the source material in the project window before it even goes into your plugins. So if you've added some plugins, you've done some mixing, and then you go change the clip gain again, then that's going to affect all of the plugins. It's going to change the sound of the track. So once you've started mixing, if you want to automate the volume, don't go to clip gain, but use volume automation. You can do that for the main fader. Or if you want to keep that one at unity gain, you can insert the volume plugin on the last pre-fader insert slot. And then you can just click the fader, add an automation lane, and it's right there. And now you can automate the volume without moving the main fader. Then folder track or group track. A folder track does not process audio. It's just for organizing and multi-track editing. So if you have drum tracks, you could create a folder track for drums. You can collapse it. And if you activate group editing, you can easily edit all tracks at the same time. If you have a multi-microphone recording and you want to do audio warp, you can use this one, phase coherent audio warp. A group track does process audio. It's an audio bus that sums all of the channels in the group. And you can add inserts, sends, just like a regular track. Next, inserts or sends. Inserts are serial processing. The output of this plugin goes into this one, the output of this plugin goes into this one, and so on. For time-related effects like reverb and delay, that's not always what you want. So if you have a reverb and also a delay, the reverb output now also goes into the delay. So you're putting a delay on the reverb. If you want more control, you can use sends. Those are parallel processing. You're just sending a copy of the dry signal to every effect. And the effects are on their own channel, so there's a whole lot you can do with those. More options, more control. Last one, events or parts. This is Cubase terminology that's useful to know so you don't get confused. For MIDI, this is an event. For audio, this is an event. And if you want to go even further, an audio event is just a reference to an audio clip in your pool. That's why you can make any kind of edit to an audio event non-destructively, because the actual audio clip is safely in your pool. And you can go even deeper, but that might be a new dedicated tutorial. So what's a part? A part is a container for events. For MIDI, this is a part. For audio, you can create a part. Select some events and go to audio events to part. Or you can use a contextual menu. On Mac, that's control click. On Windows, I'm not sure, let me know. And this is useful if you want to move around several smaller events. Or if you want to render something with silence so it matches the grid. Just a few examples. So I hope that helped. If it did, please leave a like, leave a sub, and have fun making music.